So it's booktubeathon day 6 right now, and this is the beginning of my vlog. So welcome to my channel. My name is Megan, if you don't know, and I talk about bookish things and do bookish stuff on my channel. So here we go. So yeah, today is day 6 of booktubeathon. I can't believe it's almost coming to an end. I'm actually super sad that we only have 2 days left of this, because this has been such a fun week and I have just had so much fun with the challenges, the Instagram challenges, the video challenges, and all that jazz, and reading. Even though I've only read 2 books so far, I swear I've almost finished my 3rd book. Where is it? We've got The Book of Dust. I'm almost finished this. I have 135 pages left to go, and it's getting really good. Like, it's getting really intense, so I'm sure I'm gonna finish this within a few hours today. And then I'm gonna start on my next book, which the next book that I want to read is The Sacred Lies of Middle Bly. I know this wasn't on my TBR originally, but I really want to read this because I was watching the new episodes and I was on the show, and it's like a mystery thriller, so I feel like it's just gonna suck me in, and I really want to know what happens next. Like, I'm burning with curiosity because I've watched the first like 4 episodes of the TV show, and I just want to know. Even though I kind of already know a good portion of what happens on the TV show because I was on it, as I mentioned in my other vlogs, so I know how some of the story wraps up, but I don't know everything, and I'm really curious to see how it all kind of ends and goes together. I did read the first like 30 pages when I first picked it up at my friend's house, so I've technically already started it, and this is gonna replace Ready Player One because I'm not gonna finish that book. So listen to 6 hours of it today and tomorrow to finish it, and that is like really impossible. I mean, if that happens, then I'll just add it to my list, but I really wanna read this one, and I feel like, like I said, it's a mystery, so it's just gonna like suck me kind of in. And it's not even 400 pages, so it's not as long as some of my other books, which I picked like the worst books for this readathon. I'm seriously so terrible. But yeah, that is the next book that I'm gonna read once I finish The Book of Dust. The other book that I was supposed to read that has green on the cover is The Reaper at the Gates, but this book is like, it's like 430 pages. I am like, I might start this if I finish The Sacred Lies today. I might start this tomorrow, but I am not gonna finish it because I have a life and I have things to do. I know, right? All I wanna do is read and watch booktubeathon videos and film. But sadly, I have other things that need to be done. So I'm not gonna finish this. I might start it tomorrow, but I really wanna start it and get into it so that I can get this finished, because I really do wanna see what happens in the next book. And to see how like it wraps up. I'm not even sure if this is the last book, if it's a trilogy or if there's another one after, but I just kind of want to know what happens to the characters, because the last one left off on some cliffhangers and some like, ooh, what's gonna happen? And I know this is gonna be intense. So if I can start this tomorrow, that would be great, but I'm sure as hell I'm not gonna finish it. There's no way that's happening. But I'm gonna push myself the last couple of days to read more. Today I don't really have anything else to do, and it is kind of hot outside, so I'm not gonna go for a super long walk with my dog. We're just gonna go around the little forest area beside my house, and I'll probably take her for another walk in the evening when it cools down a little bit, because I don't want to go out in the heat. Yeah, so that's all for this little segment of the vlog. I hope you've been enjoying my vlog so far. I don't know if they're any good, but I just had fun making them and talking to a camera, so that is gonna be all.
There was a time when I was alone, nowhere to go and place to call home. My only friend was the man in the moon, and even sometimes he would go away too. Then one night as I closed my eyes, I saw a shadow flying high. He came to me with the sweetest smile, told me he wanted to talk for a while. He said, Peter Pan, that's what they call me. Promise that you'll never be lonely. And ever since that day.
Hey guys, so I just read like a ton of The Book of Dust. I sat and I read for an hour after I took the dog for a walk. I've got it here. I've only got about another 23 pages left to read, so I'm gonna finish that in about an hour. What I'm just doing right now, I'm in the dining room and I'm putting away this card game we have. I'll show you what it looks like. It's a bit of a mess, and it's like a complicated board game, so I've got to put everything back right in the right spots, in the correct boxes. So So that's gonna take me a little bit. So I was just sitting and watching BookTube videos while I was doing that. And then I'm gonna take a little break after I do this, read a little bit more, maybe finish the Book of Dust, and then I'm gonna start editing my vlog that I did for the last 2 days. I'm gonna edit probably for about half an hour, an hour, and maybe I'll finish before the next sprint starts, because I wanna participate in sprints on Twitter, because I haven't actually ever really done that. I'm really bad at participating in like sprints, so I wanna try that out. In between the sprints, I'll be making myself some food, and then after the sprints are over, I'm going to take a break from reading, watch a little bit of BookTube, and then I'm going to post the vlog, and then chill after that, and maybe finish the book that I have next on my TBR. I'm really just pushing myself today. I do have like one or two other chores that I have to get done, but I did some yesterday, so I'm not too bad on that account. Yeah, that's pretty much all I have to update you on so far. Now I'm watching a chapter from Aisha. I'll show you. My computer. Oh, I've got two videos open. One's Alex from Alex Fiction Addiction, and the other is Aisha from a chapter from Aisha. I was just on Twitter, and then I clicked on her video, and I'm also watching my watch later list, which is this one here. So yeah, that's my computer. I'm not watching them both at the same time, obviously, but I was just making my way through my watch later list to get through some of my booktubeathon videos. It's 12:20 right now, and I'm gonna end this little bit. I will update you guys in a couple more hours, probably before I start the next sprint. So yeah. Bye for now. That day,
I am a lost boy from Neverland, usually hanging out with Peter Pan. And when we're bored, we play in the woods, always on the run from Captain Hook. Run, run, lost boy, they say to me.
So it's 5 o'clock right now. I had my food and I finished my book, The Book of Dust, and I really enjoyed this. It was really good. It took a while to get like to pick up. It started off slow, and like halfway through the book it started to get faster. And I really, really enjoyed it, and I can't wait to read the second and third and see where we go with this series. I'm not sure where exactly the next two books are gonna go, but I believe this is like a trilogy. So I'm curious to see as to where this is going to go with next. So we'll see what that happens. I've also started this book, which I had already started a few days ago, but I like picked up where I left off because I'm really curious to see what happens. Again, this is like mystery thriller, some rough, mature subjects in here, so just be warned if you're like, oh, that looks interesting, just be warned, trigger warnings for those kind of things. But I'm really curious just to see what's gonna happen next, and I think I'm probably gonna stay up late finishing this, because this is just like a kind of a fast-paced mystery thriller kind of novel, so I don't think it's gonna take me like too long to read. I did participate in a sprint today. It was a Disney themed one. I didn't participate in as much as I wanted to because we went over to say hi to our neighbors and their baby, because they have a 10-week-old baby and she's so adorable. And we offered her some baby clothes that we have lying around, but they already have a whole bunch apparently. So that's fine. But the baby was so adorable, and I said hi to their dog as well, and our dogs met through the fence and sniffed each other's noses, and so cute. But anyway, that's all for this segment of the vlog. I'll update you guys once more tonight, maybe, and tomorrow I'll definitely update you. So I hope the booktubeathon is going well for you guys. I hope you've been enjoying this week. I know that I'm gonna be uploading this like Monday, so it's gonna be over by this point, but I hope that you are enjoying it so far, because I'm having a lot of fun, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Hey, hey guys, I've tried to film this clip a few times, but it's failed. I'm just ending the vlog for today. I just wanted to let you guys know that I have read some more of The Sacred Lies of Minnow Bligh, but it's a little after 9 now, and I was just editing my vlog, and I'm gonna post that before the day's over, and I'm gonna do my exercises, and then I'm gonna go to bed and read a little bit of this while I'm in bed. I'm enjoying it, but it is a little bit dark, and my arm is getting tired now though, so I'm gonna end this. I'm just gonna say goodnight. I hope you've enjoyed BookTubeathon, because if you're watching this, it's over, and I'm sad, probably, but I'm probably chilling and not reading quite as much. Anyway, I'm gonna end this vlog now. I hope you guys are all doing well. Good morning. It is the last day of booktubeathon, and I am here with some reading updates for you. So I stayed up till almost midnight finishing this book here, Sacred Lies, Middle Lie, and I really enjoyed it. Except I didn't like the ending as much as I was hoping to. It's kind of an open-ended ending, like, it doesn't really give you, like, couldn't tell you exactly what happened, so it leaves a lot up to your imagination, which isn't always my favorite way for books to end. I want to know what happens, and it didn't quite tell you everything that happens, but it was still a good book, and the ending wasn't terrible. I just kind of wanted a little bit more from it. I kind of wanted to know what happened to the characters. I'll talk more about it in my wrap-up though, but yeah, I finished this book and I have started the next book on my TBR, which is another pick book because I was just really stupid for this readathon, and that is Reaper at the Gates, and I'm 50 pages into it. I caught the last 15 minutes of a sprint, and so I read a little bit, but you know what? I feel like I can do it. I am also going to do the challenge for today because I love the challenge. I think it is so great being able to talk about your favorite books, and it's been kind of hard to pick one, but I think I know what I'm going to talk about. It's going to be something to do with a book that I read a lot and that I loved as a kid. That's all I have to update you for now. I'll update you probably later in the evening because I've got to go out today and do things. Hey guys, so right now it is 5 o'clock and I haven't gotten a chance to read anything else. Like, it's been a busy day for me, and because of that I'm not gonna finish this book because I only read like 63 pages, and I'm finding that like it's good. I'm just not really that into it right now. So this was my one for green on the cover, and I wanted to complete like most of the challenges. So I'm switching this one out last minute. I'm putting in this little book, Quidditch Through the Ages. It's green, and I don't know why I didn't think of it before. Probably I've read it, I think I've read the whole thing, I'm not even 100% sure. But it's like 55 pages of just cute, fun knowledge, and I'm gonna be staying up late-ish tonight to like read some of this and to get some other stuff done. I feel like I could finish A Torch Against the Night, or A Reaper at the Gates. I probably could if I like sat down for like 4 hours, and I could probably finish it. I just don't really want to push myself because I feel like I'm not going to enjoy that book if I try and force myself to finish it in one night. So I kind of didn't choose the best books for this. But because of that, I'm going to go for this one. And I also have here a little comic Archie book that I'm just going to read as well. And that way I'll have read 6 books. I just have been pushing myself, and I've read a lot of bigger books, so I just kind of decided to switch it out and go with these ones. And that'll still only be 6 books unless I get around to a 7th smaller book, but unlikely because I'm not that interested in pushing myself to get an email that says I complete a booktubeathon. I mean, it would be fun, but unlikely because I've only got like another 7 hours of booktubeathon left, and I'm uploading my challenge for the day right now. I just finished editing that, so I'm gonna upload that. I also wanted to show you guys what I just got, which I'm pretty excited about. It has nothing to do with books though, so I hope that this is interesting, but I got my new rock polisher because my previous one died a few days ago, and I ordered this one and it came in really fast, and here it is. I opened it. It tumbles like this, and it tumbles and cleans the rock with sand. It's for the jewelry that I'm making because I have a bunch of rocks already, and I have a bunch of amethyst that me and my family got when we were in an amethyst mine a few years ago, and I want to polish that. I've also got some rocks here that need to be polished, and that's gonna take months to do, but it's a lot of fun, and I've got the sand and all the parts, and this is kind of what the finished products look like of the necklaces that I've been making. I have a few other ones here. These are some of the styles that I've been trying out. These little ones, I'm gonna make some bracelets as well. I've got some earrings that are just kind of like studs with rocks on them that I've made, but I can't wear them because I only have one hole in my ear and I didn't really think I needed any others. So yeah. Anyway, that is my general plan for the rest of the day. I have a lot of BookTube videos to catch up on. I have so many to catch up on. Oh my gosh. But this has been such a fun week, and I'm really sad that it's coming to an end. I have thoroughly enjoyed myself. But yeah, I'm also a little bit nervous to upload this new video for the challenge today. I really like the challenge, but I kind of got a little bit personal when I was talking about one of my favorite books. But I hope you guys like the video anyway. I don't know, but yeah. Enough for this little clip. I will come back with you guys later tonight when the readathon is almost over. Then I will just let you know what I've read, if I finished any more books, and how it's been going for me. Goodbye. He was getting into stuff. Hey guys, sorry, I'm holding my camera if it's a little wobbly there. I was just participating in the last sprint for BookTubeathon, and I was reading this, and I'm almost finished it, but there's so much good stuff in this book. I just forget how much it makes me laugh. Although, the beginning, I was like a little bit annoyed because it says, "All that remains for me is to thank you for supporting comic relief and to beg Muggles not to try Quidditch at home. It is, of course, an entirely fictional sport and nobody really plays it." Excuse me, I play Quidditch. I've played it before and it is a sport. It's an actual sport. Like, people play Quidditch. I've seen sports teams play Quidditch against each other. Like, you don't fly on brooms, but it is an actual sport. So, what are you talking about, book? This is an actual sport. But I am almost finished this book, and BookTubeathon has just ended for everybody else in most of the world. I still have like 3 hours left because it's 9 o'clock now, but I'm gonna be finishing this book, and I have my Archie's comic book that I might start, but I do have several things that I wanna do before today's over, so I don't know if I'll finish that. It would only be 6 books for the week anyway. I wouldn't technically be completing BookTubeathon because the books that I just had were just so big and huge in my TBR, except for this one I switched out, right? Because I just needed something a little bit more relaxing and fun and chill. And the other fantasy one, I want to take it slower. But I might update you guys later and let you guys know if I've read any more. I'm definitely going to finish this because I've only got like 5 pages left. But it is hilarious and it's constantly making me laugh with their mention of Canadian Quidditch teams, Moose Jaw Meteorites, Haley Burry Hammers, and Stonewall Stormers. I just love the Moose Jaw Meteorites. Like, that is so funny. This book is really entertaining. It's only like 54 pages though, so it didn't really take me very long to read, which was good because I didn't have a lot of time, but I will be updating you guys one more time probably tonight, and I will be doing a wrap up, so I'll let you know like how many pages I read and like in more detail what I thought of the books if you're interested. So that is all for this segment. I will see you guys one more time to say goodbye. I can't believe BookTubeathon's over. Why? Oh my gosh, this is so sad.
Together we will fly away in a cloud of green to your beautiful destiny. As we soared above the town that never loved me, I realized I finally had a family.
Is it Isla Nublar? You know which one I mean. It's like that kind of setting. What I will say about this is that the writing style is not slow.
Hi guys, I just showed you what my computer, and I was watching a BookTuber, Becca, and her books. I really like her videos. I've been catching up on all the BookTube vlogs on my watch later list. There's so many videos. There's almost 40, and BookTubeathon hasn't even fully come to an end yet. It almost is. I've got another 40 minutes left, but I have finished Quidditch Through the Ages. So I completed 5 challenges. I completed 5 books. I completed all the challenges except the last one, which was to read 7 books. But we all knew that that wasn't gonna happen. That's just not me. But I really enjoyed finishing off this book for the day, and I have a couple other books that I'm gonna be reading this week, so I'm pretty happy with that. It's been a fun week, a lot of challenges. I've gained some new subscribers, so thank you for subscribing to my channel. I have found new people to subscribe to, new BookTubers to watch, new smaller BookTubers, and I am very happy about that. And that's all for this vlog. I'm pretty tired, so I'm gonna go to bed. I'm going to end off this vlog here. That's it. I know I haven't really done much for today, but I'm gonna end this vlog now, and I will see you guys in my BookTubeathon wrap-up when I actually discuss all the books that I read and what I thought of them, and I'll let you know how many pages I read and my stats in that video. So Thank you so much again for watching, and I hope that your booktubeathon week went well and you were able to read as much as you wanted to. And I'm going to go to bed now because I look like a complete and utter mess. I am such trash right now. Good night. Goodbye.